thank you for that, and how lovely to step into space that's been prepared by that music. Glorious stuff. Just a few words on poetry competition process first. A, it feels impossible to judge. B, it probably is impossible. And C, and we do it. And it works. However, I often wonder if I'm the wrong person to be judging poetry competitions at all. What you need is one of those haughty old blokes, we have to admit they are mainly old blokes, who feel there's only a tiny amount of true poetry in the world, written by a tiny number of true poets whose job is to stamp out all the rest. I saw nothing in this whole entry that I wanted to stamp out. There were quite a few that if I'd been in a room with the writer, I'd have asked, okay, what do you want this poem to be good for? Because there are plenty of other things in the world poetry can be good for. Other than a particular sort of standing on its own and winning competitions. After that, we could have sat down and talked, and there would be lots of questions, and questions are good. So really, that's my confession, that the place I feel most at home with the life of poetry is in the workshop, in the process of doing and becoming, rather than at the end, whatever we call the end of the process and the summary judgment. But no, this is the game. This is what we agree to do with each other, not because it delivers an absolute truth, but because, by and large, good competitions serve the cause of poetry. They offer goals, deadlines, comradeship of an odd kind, and guaranteed attention, all of which help us bring half-formed things into focus and get it done. The fact is that there were a daunting number of genuinely interesting poems in that entry. Poems with more than just a flicker of life in them. Poems with an alertness for the world and a twist of fresh seeing and speaking. And the more achieved they were, the more they had started to become uniquely themselves, the more dissimilar, the more chalk and cheese they were. So, how to choose? I could list criteria and still leave out that small, vital thing that one can't name. In the end, what I trust most is time. The test of what stays with me and pulls me back for a third or fourth reading, and is stubbornly, no, increasingly, itself. By the time I've narrowed down to a short list of, say, 12, I know, that stage confession here, that I could have made out a plausible argument for any of them being on the list of winners. I don't say I would have believed it myself. Many people live there. But still, we weren't quite there. I'm not saying this to take any of the gloss from our named winners. They are all there for a good reason. They're each and differently excellent, lovely things. There was a reason why each of them stuck in the round after round of reading. Even at the stage when I was reduced to hunting for little peccadilloes, flaws, faults, I'm stuck in it, screwed that one, can't I? Oh no, I can't. And when the smoke cleared in the end, these were the ones that were still sitting there, utterly, unavoidably being themselves. At that point, fair enough, I had to say, I give up, you win. But as if to prove the point that I was making there, we have got no third prize, but we have two equal seconds. Because I think the first two things you'll hear on stage in a completely arbitrary order are so different in style and form and intention and everything from each other, that the kind of excellence I think each of them has can't be compared with each other. They are in a small way incompatible.